just to stop this world from spinning. Like Superman, you were the only one to find the strength in all that I was dealing with. This life like kryptonite. And if you keep me close every minute in this hourglass, you hope.
Everybody, and welcome back to another Satisfactory stream. We are currently on day 12, and this is going to be kind of a grindy, buildy sort of thing. So, yeah, we're going to jump right into it. So, since the last stream, we've done a few things. Let's just quickly go over. I'm trying to remember, I had a day off yesterday, I didn't come on this thing at all. So, yeah, pretty much everything on these is all like full. I can't remember if these were expanded the last time or not, but what we have done is we have set up set up the double sort of storage for steel, so we're getting a fair bit of that coming in. And down here I've made a couple of alterations because we're going to be working on the base either today or in the next stream, and I'll just run over what we've got on here. Right, okay, let's get the let's get this little fellow on the go. Right, so we should be able to travel around the base a little bit faster. So I'll show you what I've done. I've built a couple of temporary, well, a temporary walkway down here, and I have sort of worked out where I want my conveyors. So over here, this is where the conveyor feed will be. These are currently just Mark 1 belts, because obviously at the planning stage I don't need to run Mark 3 belts in here and so on and so forth. I'll upgrade these as necessary when we're using them. So we're going to utilize these nodes over here, because we've got 4 impure iron nodes. I know they're not fantastic, I know they're not great, but that's what we've got to work with. We've got a couple of nodes up here as well, so we can mine all those out and extract, and we can pump them in through these belts. And obviously we're going to have a feed of iron ore coming in, we're going to have a feed of the copper, we're going to have coal coming in, we're going to have caterium coming in, we're going to have sulfur, and we're going to have quartz. So obviously these may not stay all the way out here, they're just here, I don't know what the word is that I'm looking for, temporarily, is that the word that I'm looking for? Probably not. So we can alter them, it just allows me to use them as a template. That's what this is a template, this is not what it's going to be later on. And we're going to do something funky when we've got like glass walls and stuff, because we can make this thing bigger, obviously, because we probably need more than one iron feed belt. So what my plan is there is to have a second iron feed belt coming in over the top, and we'll double up all the feed belts as and if required. That's my plan for that. Right, let's get him running. So we've got all this space to play with, there's quite a lot of it. And obviously this is going to be multiple floors. And I've been playing with a few things down below. I know this cart's not great to go down here with, just like that. Oh wow, that was pretty funky. We really do need to set up a race course or something for this thing. So yeah, we're gonna have to jump out of here, so I'm not gonna make that. So the other thing I've got is I've got these things that I have bought from the shop, and I love these. I think these look awesome, and so I'm gonna, obviously this one's not staying here because I need this to go over to there to that island. So I've joined my base to that one over there. Oh hi, hello, how are you doing? So this is going to be like the little theme running, so I can have these to structurally support the base. But I know it's not essential because you can have just floating platforms in here, but I kind of like them. I think they look very industrial, and that's I want that in my base. So there's Doggo, there's Gizzard the lizard. Right, okay, so power wise we will go over and we'll go over on what's happening with the power. We've got some no, before we go, this thing was set to make modular frames. I'll just take those out and refill that. This is still on reinforced iron plates, so probably want a good thing. Oh, you have a fully working power plant. I'm still having issues with mine. And I'll go over that very shortly on what's happened and what's gone wrong with the thing. Right, okay, so we need rods. Why can't I access that? Right, we'll take some rods with us. And I think we need wire. We definitely do need some concrete. I'm sure we do. I'm sure we've got plenty of this over there, but we'll take a couple more anyway. And what do we like for cables? We'll grab a stack of those. Don't need any of that thing over there. Right, okay. Oh, you're going to be doing a factory tour when you get back. Oh, that's pretty cool. My factory's still very much a work in progress at this present point in time. But what I have done is I have sort of built, as you can see down there, I have power lines, and it is running down to the fuel generators, but it obviously it's not connected to the base as yet. I don't want to rely on that power until I've got it all completely working. And by the way, hello, I think I have solved the mob problem on what it is that why they respawn. I did some science into it, and it seems that if you kill a mob on here and you don't build, it will allow the mob to respawn back into its location, whereas if you place a structure or something like that, it won't allow that mob to respawn. I'm pretty certain that that is the case, because ever since I've placed these power lines, I've never had another mob respawn. So, and I did take out that blue alpha as well, even though I did cheese it. I crushed him with a truck, and then he glitched to the truck, and then I just jumped out and just whacked him with the Xeno Zapper until he was mincemeat. So, yeah, I did take all the power lines. Now, see, I've got that power line just there because I don't know the radius of the thing, the radius of the build between, and so that power line is where bees would spawn. I just don't want to keep coming back. And over in the distance over there, you can see the fuel generator. And that's where I did a lot of lobster in from. I'm leaving that right there. It's going to be my little lookout tower. I've got to do something with that further on. Right, let's go over and take a look at the... fuel generation, because I have some issues with this. Park this around here next to the new tractor. Right. Here we go. Right, this might make your head hurt a little bit. They're all temporary because I've got an issue with the refinery itself. This one at the moment should be off. Yeah, this is off completely. That is a normal crude oil node. And over here somewhere, we have... bus lag. Yeah, I was wondering why that was there then for a second. It was just a temporary thing. So this one is a pure node, and this is where we're running all our oil from. So this is the feed pipe, so the crude oil, and we're getting a really good flow rate down here because it's all straight. So this comes in down here, swoops around here and up to here, and we've still got a good flow rate all the way across. And we are currently feeding 3 rubber factories because we get the 20 minute per hour, 20 per minute, 20 per hour, 20 per minute oil. Obviously, I really do need plastic because that's really important. Oils, rubber, I don't think has a point. So we've got really good flow rates into these. They're constantly filling. I'm really good with that. This is the downside. Now I've got this horrendous pipe set up right now. This is going to be turned to a like a a manifold design. Obviously that's not going to be there. These obviously will be there because this is where the product's going to flow above. So the feed to this is good. We're getting a really good feed. We're getting a really good feed into this one. And this one, we're also getting a good feed. So we're getting a good backlog of oil over here. And over here, okay, it's going to call me a liar now, because these were starving for the fuel. That's why I turned this one. Oh, is it when I turn this one on, it all goes weird? I think this actually all goes weird over here with the fuel thing. This is a mess. Look at that. I mean, I thought it looked quite industrial, but now I just think it looks like a complete mess. So I'm going to change this to a manifold design too. So we'll have to move these power poles out the way. Probably from here, create a pipeline all the way down, keep it nice and straight, all the way down to this, and we'll feed literally straight into each one. Now I want to check the flow rates, because that one was always staying at 50, and this one, however, was dropping constantly, and it wasn't nice. It's calling me a liar. That's not... Right, okay, so we don't have a fuel problem. We did, and now we don't. See, now this is dropping. And then when this, the back thing, but yet we have got this always full, so I don't quite understand why this drops so badly. Because this should be producing, that should be producing constantly. And I don't understand why it's not. But you know what, it's working fine for now. So that will allow me to carry on with this sort of setup. But I'm going to run out of space very, very soon. And obviously I'm only running rubber, and I'd want rubber and plastic. So maybe I could put plastic refineries here and here. Oh, you can't see because I've got these stupid things in the way. So I've got to this space at the edge of this, so I should be able to fit two more refineries in here running plastic, and that'll just be excess. So we'll do like three rubber, two plastic, three rubber, two plastic, three rubber. And that should get us, what, three, six, nine fuel generators. Put one on half to fix the problem. Well, I'm going to be running plastic into these pipes anyway, because obviously I'm going to have a lot more thing, and I'm not going to add any extra fuel generators to the plastic. So I'll put two plastic, one refinery here, and then pipe it in. That should solve any feed problem. That's my theory anyway. I think that's the right thing to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my stuff and I'm going to start putting it all together. But I've been putting crates all over the place. Look, I'm in a right mess. I don't know what I've... Oh, did I put some crates over here? I probably did. I think I moved everything over here. Oh, so, yeah, everything's in here. So, I should have computers, motors, everything that I need. I've got some heavy modular frames, cables, cement. I don't know if we need these or not. I think we've got everything that we need to build more of these, so I'm going to start popping these down. Production. Right, we're going to go with the refinery. What we're missing? Encased steel. Okay, I thought I brought nearly 200 of them things. Oh, there we are. I did 200. Oh, you're home now. So, no more lag then, I guess. Right, let's get these things built. I can sit here talking all day about it. I need to get them done. So, control that. I think that's in the right place. Yeah. Control, get that built. So there's two plastic. These are going to be the three. One, two, jump. One, two, three. They're going to be three rubber. Two plastic. Why can't we build what we run out of? Pipes, we've got plenty of those. Grab some of those out of the truck. Okay, I'll have to grab those from here then. Obviously. I should have brought more of those with me. Right, further down here. Oh, I've lost count now. So, two plastic. One, two, three rubber. So we're on out of two plastic. Whoops. So there's the two plastic, and now we need three rubber. One. Two. And we're running out of now motors. Marvellous. So, yeah, we've got quite a few of these refineries now. What did we run out of? Motors. Motors. 50 more. I think I'm going to have to craft more of those things. I really should have set the base, the main base, to be building motors while I was over here. So I think I have all the kit to do it. Now I've lost how many. Every time I run back there, I lose how many refineries that I'm putting in. So, one, two, three, that's oil. Two, plastic. One, two, three. No. One, two. Oh, I'm just counting again. Stupid Swifty. Oh, you're a moron. One, two, plastic. One, two, three, rubber. Two plastic. One, two, three rubber. Blah, blah, blah. Da, da, da. Right, okay. So, now we need to build. We need to get this thing out of the way. So that's going to cause a problem. Let's just go and build a setup over here. It's a temporary storage setup over here. Keep it out of the way. Industrial storage unit. Why are you not lining up? Oh, it can't line up, can it? So, because I've got that elevator on there. Oh, it can. That's weird. Why didn't it do it all the way down here? Or is it? Or is there a limit to the thing? Yeah, there's obviously a limit to it, so. You know, it's roughly about here, and I'm going to fall off the edge. You know I am. Okay, that should be out the way. Then I can put loads of rubber in here. That's going to be an issue. Oh, do you know what? I can just crate it for now. Let's just get rid of this. Oh, no, 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 no. No, no. Don't get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. And get rid of that. hopefully I can take a... It's too long, is it? Sad. Okay. Right, well, that's that issue solved. Now we should be able to delete that stand and that stand. And inside here, we should have tons of rubber. Three. Two. I bet there's like one in S6. Okay, so that's a thing. Obviously we'll sort this pipe network out later, because obviously I want this nice and square. I don't want it all bleh. But I also want these square, so I want this one in the middle of these two. For it, hit hope. That's the right lane. Is that it? No, that's not it. I want it level there. Is, and that gives me enough space to do all my little bits that I need to do in it inside, and then hopefully I'm level with this to that. Oh no, there's only two of these. I want that in the middle of these. Not one there, and one there. Okay. Same situation again. It's going to be hitting hope. Oh. This one should go right next to it. There. Run out of pipes again. So we'll fill up on those. You're underestimating how many steel pipes it is that I was going to need for this thing. I think I've got two left. And I've got loads of them in the base too. Was there any over... back to the base just to go and get, I think this is all rubber and plastic. Rubber. So now I can empty this into there. I've probably got enough rubber now to last me for the rest of the season. I know I'm going to have to turn these on periodically as well, aren't I? Like with the excess power for them, is turn this cell on, the generator turns on the next cell, next gen, blah blah blah. So this is all straight, obviously I can't run around it, there's a gap in the middle, and get these out of the way. These are freaking me out now. Whoops. Keep hitting that. Take all. I get all. Let's try this. That works. Dump this rubber. Still nothing. I'll let you know when I know anything, but like I said, if I don't hear anything back this week, I'm gonna look at just starting my own and do it that way. Oh, hi there. Okay, I'm not sure how you pronounce your name. Is it Cushel? Cushelly B? Sorry if I've got that wrong. How are you doing? Shelly B. Right, okay, we got that. Right, we got it. How you doing? Oh, you're a new player. I've not been playing too long. I'm probably just out of the noob stage now, I think. But how long have you been playing? How many hours have you got into the game? We can store all that stuff in there. Oh, 2 days. I'm on this one. I'm about, if you see there, I've got like 44, I'm almost 45 hours in to this, but probably around about 6 of those hours I was AFK, because I needed steel and things for this monstrosity that we're building. Right, okay. You have 100 hours. I have probably about 160 hours between this one and the two duo servers that I'm on. So, so we should think of a topic of the day, I think, as well. What we're going for today. We've had the discussion about Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter. We've had the discussion about ice cream. What discussion shall we have today? What's going to be the topic? I'll let you guys decide. I'll pick something stupid. Right. So, am I going to fit 3 of these bulky mad things in here? Should be able to. 1, 2, 3. Could look a bit funky if not. I suppose we can always expand out the side if I need to. But I really need to get another one of these power plants built. Future later. Oh, we use a lot of rubber on them, don't we? It's a good job we didn't stockpile all that rubber then. So how are you finding the game anyway, Cashelli? Are you enjoying it? Right, we can do this mess. Do you know what? I'm going to go back to the main base. Why? Because I can show sort of Cashelli around the main base as well. Obviously this is just a power plant, or it will be when it's finished. In theory, because I need some more of those pipes, the steel pipes anyway. So we'll run back to the main base, and then I'll give you a little bit of a tour around the base, so you've got an idea on what we're doing on this thing. And so obviously it can be a bit daunting, because we're currently on day 12 on this world. quite a lot's happened. I really feel like I should be crafting the buggy up to do this run and not the tractor. So we'll maybe look at doing that when we're back at the base, and we'll craft a buggy up and bring a buggy down this way. Might be a lot faster. We've already got a tractor at the refinery anyway. So what sort of stage are you at, Kashali, in the game? Have you got steel and, like, what tier are you at? That's the word that I was looking for. At least I don't get lost anymore, seeing as I put this power line in. Oh, there were loads of spiders down here as well. On here they were falling like from the tree. Squished those. Oh, tier 2. Oh, so you're just roughly at like the space elevator stage then. Like, loading the space elevator with the smart plating. How did I not see that? And that, come on. Oh, you're done with phase 2. You're done with phase 2. Oh, so you're on phase 3 now. You're on the same phase as me now, then. I'm currently working towards unlocking the trains. Right, we'll park this here because I think we're going to be done with this tractor for the time being. And we'll see what it costs to do a buggy. Transport. Where is the buggy? What? Why we got no buggy? We should have a buggy in here, shouldn't we? Why don't we have a buggy? Is there something we've missed in the map to unlock a buggy? We're stuck. Under here. Oh, right, you're just building your base as well. Okay, so, right, no buggy for us then. We're gonna take the tractor. Right, okay, so Kashali, this is the temporary base, this down here. So this is where all the happiness happens. So we've got like some storage up here where our screws, rods and plates go, and obviously the storage is full at the moment. Over here we have automated reinforced plates, so this is our assembler unit. This can be easily just switched over to create rotors for us or plates. Talking of which, I probably should turn the steel line over to pipes now. So I'm taking that. This is our steel in feed, coal or iron ore into steel production, so we can make steel plates and the tubey things. Over here, this is going to be the main base, the mega base. So the mega base is going to be on this platform. It's going to be multiple floors. We're going to have all of our basic requirements coming in here, all the way down. So we're going to have like all our screws, rods, iron plates. We're going to have a copper, the basic copper elements like wire, cable, and copper sheeting, all made in here. The limestone will go into a concrification plant, some probably just round about where I'm standing now. And then we've got all this space to duplicate anything else that we need further in on the game. Obviously, we're going to have to bring quartz in at some point to turn that into crystals, but we may do that on floor two. Then floor two, we're going to have that as the assembly floor. So we'll have all our steel plates and our steel plates, steel pipes, reinforced iron plates, rotors, stators, and modular frames. I think that's going to be floor two. Then floor three will be the more heavier stuff, like heavy modular frames and motors and so on and so forth. Have we got any tickets in the awesome sink? So we've got that much concrete right now that we're just actually dropping that straight into the awesome sink to get coupons so we can buy cool stuff in the awesome shop. Oh, by the way, I've seen what that car does, by the way, that wagon with the square wheels. I came here for plenty of these because we're going to need them, and I will take some of these too. So that's pretty much our base. Oh yeah, I'll show you the miners as well. So I'm not sure what land you're on, Kishali. This one, it's kind of naff. All we seem to have is impure all the way. We have lots of impure nodes. We have five down this row, two up there, and two across over up that area. So it is kind of naff. I did say there was two up there, didn't I? And we've got some copper over the back. That's where all this happiness is feeding into. Obviously these storage units are full. So yeah, that's about it. And then we've got, this is the main concrete feed. That's on a pure limestone node. That's why we get it in huge droves. Now, I should set this up to start datas really. So we'll go to the assembler and start manufacturing that. 500 into there. Have we got any here? Take those with us. Might need meters. So, and then up at the back, obviously you'll notice we haven't got very many biomass burners over here anymore. That's just a backup thing if these pumps ever stop up here. This is our main power plant that's running our base at the moment. It just runs it and no more. So we've got a coal generator set up here, and we have a manifold of water coming in through the extractors. This thing was a headache trying to get it right. I'm sure Hello can tell you I had a bit of a headache trying to build this thing and trying to get it right. So because one factory was being powered, one wasn't, then another one was, then another one wasn't. The balance was just all over the place. So, and I sorted that out by splitting the coal feed into two, feeding two separate splitters. So that's a little tip for you if you ever, when you get to this stage, it's is split the coal and then bring it in to two different feeds so it spreads out evenly. I don't think there's anything in this box, is there? Nah, rubbish. Got crates all over the place. We're going to take some damage here, I think. So we've got what we came for. Let's find our tractor, because why can't I build a buggy? I don't understand. Why have I not got that technology open to me? Is that on a hard drive thing? The buggy. It's not in there. I mean, it's a hard drive thing. Okay. Dang it. So we're gonna have to go hunting for hard drives. Maybe not next stream, because I want next stream to go and find quartz. So maybe the one after that we'll have to go on a hard drive hunt. I know we've got that one over there. That one over there, we've got a hard drive, and there's another hard drive over there somewhere between the normal limestone and the coal. There's one over there. And I'm sure we passed one when I was looking for... Oh no, that was a tunnel. We'll have to go down there as well at some point. And I'm going to hate that, because I'm going to get flattened by spiders. No, not hard drive, but... Oh, it's under Caterium. Well, let's do it. I'm sure I have plastic kicking about this place somewhere. Where would I put it? Did I put you in this? Or did I make... Oh. We'll have to build a man where we're going. How much quick wire do we have? Because we need that, don't we? I think it's all at the base. I think it's all at the other area. And we'll do the Caterium research down there. Okay, let's pop into the buggy. Into the tractor. And we'll build a man down there and research what we need to. Probably a good idea having a man there, actually. So, my goal today is to get this power grid sorted, so we've got excess amounts of power, so I can start building this factory and not have to worry about it tripping the fuse. So we never did think of a topic of the day, so I'm not going to have to pick one. Favourite computer game of all time. What is your favourite computer game of all time ever? Love to find out what you guys think is the best computer game, in your opinion, obviously. It's a tough one, isn't it? It is, because there is a lot of good games out there. I know what mine is, but I'm going to keep mine till last. Oh, you both said that that's hard. There isn't a game actually that's called That's Hard, is there? Am I missing a trick here? Shall I just tell you mine? Mine's Super Mario Bros. 3. That's my favourite game ever. And I was around for when that came out, and I was super excited when it came out, and I was at the shop the day that it came out to buy it. Jesus Christ. Some of that, them stupid mushrooms as well, so I can build a gas mask and get rid of that rock. Oh, sorry, radiation suit, get rid of that rock. You know what? I've never played Age of Mythology. I've never actually played that game. Satisfactory is probably one of my top 10 games. My first game is going to be Super Mario Bros. 3. My second is Minecraft. And third, it's going to be a very close third between Satisfactory and Subnautica, because they're pretty similar, but they're so different. Until later on. So let's move that in line with that. That should be nice and square. And that isn't going to cause us any problems. And then that should allow us to take a feed all the way down this to create our manifold. Oh, pipe's too long. That is going to be a very, very big power plant. So we'll take this all the way down here. That should do us for now. So, what's your least favourite game that you've ever played? That might be an easier question. Straight, doesn't it? I'd say that was nice and straight. Oh, is it like Factorio? I wasn't really, if it is Factorio, off. I never got into Factorio. I didn't like the whole 2D aspect of it. I know Satisfactory is pretty much based off of Factorio, but again, at the same time, it is a completely different beast. Oh, that's why that's happening. Oh, this could be a problem. We may need to shift that slightly to that side, because them pipes are going to conflict. It's all a learning process. Oh, this manifold's going to look horrendous. But do you know what? I can always build a box around it. Yeah. You know what? It's industry. It's industry. Keeping this thing straight isn't. Well, I want the pipe network to be straight, but I'm not too bothered about this, the look of this. We're never going to see it. Out of sight, out of mind. And we can. It may look alright once it's all done, because we're going to have like quite a lot of these things. So, that was plastic and plastic. I want to set those now so we don't forget. Plastic into that. Plastic into that. And the two of those together should power one. No, they won't. They won't power one generator. Oh, they don't need to. They're to top it up. It's the rubber that powers them. I keep forgetting that. So these next three are going to be set on rubber. This one away up first. Right. Where's that green light? Snap. Snap those to there. Then another one here somewhere. This is going to be a problem, this one. Oh no, 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 no. It's not going to be a problem because it's further down. I don't know what that was snapping to. Right, okay, this is going to look a bit wonky. Right, sorry for my silence here, I'm just trying to things have got pipes going out all over everywhere. So rubber, 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 powering these two. These two are going to be on solid fuel. That's that taken care of. So solid fuel, which we haven't set yet, but this isn't going to be powering a generator. It's these two that power it. That one keeps the system topped up. We should create enough plastic out of this thing now, shouldn't we? Because seeing as we'll have four foundries. I suppose we can always put two more in at the end if we need to. Then we'll have eight foundries producing plastic and the rest producing rubber. And then what rubber that we don't need, we can just throw off into an awesome sink. So we can use the smart splitter for that. Right, let's go in ahead and build these elevators. Now I can't remember. Yes, it was that. Says it's straight, but it's obviously not. I want that much fast. We can use Mark 1 for this now. Why does that not look right? Is this drooping down, this conveyor? Oh, we can fix that in a bit, that's not a big issue. The big issue is more to get this thing, the power running. I've done all that already, so we need to turn this thing off. We need to get rid of this pipe. I can't turn that one off yet, so this is going to be a bit of a horrendous bend right here. Right, let's run right down here. Don't fall off. There. Right, okay, so that was a bit wonky there, but we can fix that. Now we can stop putting this manifold in correctly. That isn't going to work, is it? No, that's too bad. Can I sort of offset that by one? Well, that's a bit. What? Okay, this is going to take some. Why is that doing that? That shouldn't be doing that. Right, I'm in a bit of a tricky situation here. Can't move that generator. Can move this. guessing that I'm probably going to have to move this over. And line that up with that. It's all a work in progress. We'll get there. Right. Okay, that should allow us to put the two cross sections in. One there and one there. I hit control there to make it snap, and she wasn't for snapping. Right. Control, snap. That's not right. Beautiful. Right, now, that's a thing. Now this should be filling. Oh, it's got power and it's full. So we can turn this one back on. And we're still full. Right. What you do now is work out power. Put it there, or maybe even there. I don't like behind the middle. Let's just put it there. I like to try and keep everything neat as I can with power and have it like quite simple. And I should be able to put one. And then yeah, this is the main. Feed line down here. The power. So, thing there. And connect that. And we should be in business. Oh, yeah, we moved that other thing, didn't I? Come on. Need to reset this back to residual fuel. So, I've got nothing in there yet. No power. No power. Oh, did I not connect the two power lines? Yeah, I'm dumb. Right, now we should have some... Nothing yet. But we do have power. These don't have power, do they? Not open. Strange. Oh! You guys actually spot that? That I actually missed that. Okay, that's filling up nicely. Same as that, we're full. Obviously, we're not creating enough residual fuel to power a generator with these two. Because they're locked. See, it doesn't create very much. That we're looking at, is it? It's these two. And that's still not got any... It's not got no power. Oh yeah, because we're not working on those two, are we? These two. Building button, and it would go do 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 do. I also think there should be like a copy settings thing, you know, like if you build that one and you copy that with your mouse wheel, it copies the exact same settings for your next building. I think that should be in the game too. Do that. Why do you do that? is the first of the plastic. So are we getting any fuel from this? Yes, we are. Obviously it's staying idle for quite a while because it's just enough to top up the system, you know. It keeps the system full. That's what I wanted. So these should always stay on 50 now. So now it's these two are the ones that are actually going to be... Wow, there's fuel all the way inside there. So now let's connect the next ones up and we should be able to start the generators. The next set of generators. Oh, but we need more than one power plant, don't we? Motors. We've run out of motors. And I think we actually have run out of motors now. Oh, we never built that MAM, did we, either? So, let's go remedy that while it's topping itself up. Should we build the MAM down here or should we build it on the platform? What do you think would be better? Should we build it on here or should we build it down there? Build it down. Okay, we'll build it down here. Special, what a... Welcome to the MAM. Criterion. This we need to unlock, and we do have plenty of plastic. Yes, we do have plenty of plastic. Over there. Start research. Is it in a caterium tree? Because isn't that the last power pole? Or do I need to research this? No. Okay, right, I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna look on the wiki. Explorer. How to obtain. Quartz research. Yeah, it's quartz. How far are we away from quartz here? I bet we're thousands of meters away. Yeah, 1,500. That's a long way away. Oh, they look to be like right next to each other near enough. So, for now that's a pipe dream. Should we go splatificate the bees? Whoops, I missed you. Power slug. Build something here to stop these respawning. Gotcha. Alright, let's just stick a power pole here. We'll get that shortly. What else is around here? Bit of exploring, we might as well explore the island that we're on. Oh, what is this? Samor. What does that do? It does nothing. Marvellous. So this island's pretty much... Oh, hello. Well, that didn't give us much of that, did it? I was kind of hoping it would give us a little bit more... than the amount we got for that. I mean, let's go and have a little quick look over here, see if there isn't any more little quartz nodes kicking about. Might as well do a bit of exploring. Gonna be over here quite a lot. That's limestone, isn't it? Oh, gold power slug. Wow. And we have an alpha. Whee! Come on. Come on. Whee. Oh, one more and we're out of here. Well, that was a... We probably should put some berries in our mouth. So we've got a yellow power slug. So, is that more quartz? There's going to be one of these blue spitters around here somewhere, isn't there? How do we get that? 33. So what's that? We've got 50 quartz now. Limestone, you can stay, I don't need you. Anything else over here? No. Some nuts over there. Limestone. Have you explored this area? Hello. Is there anything like interesting around here? Oh, there's a. Oh, that's a purple power slug, isn't it? Under there. There tends to be like a little crack in these that you can normally get through without blowing it up. Well, we know there's a purple power slug right there once we get sulfur. We just need the sulfur technology. So that's this island pretty much explored. Oh, there's some more quartz right here. Oh no, we've got 47 in total. Dang flabbit. We are going to have a proper exploring episode one day. And explore the map properly. Right, what can we do with quartz now? We need to make 100 of those things. Is that even doable? No, we'll make 27. Salmon. We'll keep that in the container. Oh, it's not that, it's this. We'll process this into whatever it is that's. So you obviously need a lot of quartz then. Should we go off topic and go and find quartz? I really want the buggy. So I don't want to take everything with me. So I'll just take necessary stuff. That, some of that. What else could we possibly need? Do with some of that maybe for platforms. Some of that up. We need a workshop to get prepared for this. But we can put it so it's not. Craft up some of these for the Reaver gun. Just in case we find some spitters. That's everything that we really need. No, let's go and make up some portable miners and a beacon. One beacon and maybe five of these fellows. We'll go for that one that was like, is it 1,500 away or something? Oh, that was close to that radiation thing. I don't think it should take us too long to get there, really, in the tractor. Oh, there's lots of these things. I want to try to find some of them strange funguses too. Well, you're here for a reason. Go. safe at the moment. This looks a bit safe. Rescan. So it was that way. How do we get down there? Location. Well, that was close. 200 this way. Oh, there's a geyser. Oh yeah, that's gonna happen, isn't it? Two of them. Don't want them near each other. Right. Glitch one in the truck. This one I want to glitch into the truck. That should do it. Oh no, it respawned. Is that it? Is it glitched? Whoa! Friend are never coming back. Right, let's get some bacon. This is fun. Okay, so next one. Truck. I'm Cheesed it. And you, my friend, are never coming back. Alright, let's stick some things down. And we have quartz. Also pure. I'm guessing that probably all of those are pure then. Bacon. And just copper. Right, I want to set up a beacon as well for this location. Right. Oh. Right, quartz, and we'll set that to a lovely pinky colour. So, I'm going to stay here until my inventory is full and the other thing's inventory is full too. Where's my tractor? There, you can see it because of the things. Quartz. Better to put my things back into my hand. Oh, when I seen them spitters originally, I thought I was starting to panic a little bit. I've always had a problem with them blue ones, but for some reason that hardly even damaged me when I was up close to its face. And yet the one near the base, the one near on the way back from between the base and the fuel power plant, that almost killed me in one hit. How many follow you? Oh, is that why there was two spitters up here, I wonder? We need to come back here. Well, that's a bit glitchy, isn't it? Waterfall that just doesn't go anywhere. Come back for you. Now we know where you are. Obviously going to need to somehow bring we're somehow going to have to bring a conveyor line or something out of here. Oh, waterfall. I don't understand that. I just don't get it. It's a beautiful looking cave. Oh, look at that. Oh, there's a little hidden-y thing in inside here. So this is a place we're going to have to definitely come back to once we've got black powder unlocked. Rescue the poor purple slug up there, collect all the bacon that's in the walls, and find out where that little mystery rock thing. We'll see where that leads. I wish I'd have brought ladders. I wish I'd have unlocked the ladders and brought them so I would go up there and get that. For ramps, I'd have to be miles away. What's this? Caterium. We've got plenty of caterium. We don't need that. And that was copper. Plenty of that as well. Once we're full of quartz, we should have enough quartz for a while. Is quartz something that we need, like, absolutely loads of? Or is it just something that we just use now and again? Oh, you use loads of it. Okay, so we will have to somehow get this out of here and get it to a smelter. Is it not smelter? Is it a constructor to turn it into crystals? Sulfur. You know what? To me, this looks like a path. We're gonna do it. We're gonna go up here. Ugh, I didn't think I was gonna make that. And we'll collect yon bacon. What's this? Iron. We don't need iron. Where was Sluggy McGee? Up there. So do we need to climb this, climb that, and then climb over there to get that? This could be instant death at any point. Oh, we just made that. I think that may be the end of the road.
with.
Right, zoop mode. Oh, I need a platform first, don't I? Oh no, I don't want solid concrete. No, zoop. Okay, why are we changing the thing and we're not zooping? Yeah, we know this.
I'm kind of glad you didn't pick up. I kind of just called to hear your voice. I miss you.
Why are we not?
I've been thinking about you. I've been thinking about our love.
Oops.
I miss you.
Are we not?
Because
with the zoopy zoopy here.
And I just thought
of you.
The idea of you listening to this, the thought of you on the other side of the line, I can't hang up. I don't
want to. We're never going to get down there.
Not again.
How do we get down?
I hope you do.
I sort of thought I might have to build a platform down. I'm guessing that is going to be the case. That's why I master dismantled all that. I think I should have left my platform though. I didn't think it was going to let me build it then. I was starting to panic. Right, ramp. Let's get down here. Soup.
What I became so used to, what I thought would be forever.
Deep in the dark, down on my knees, I've seen things that you wouldn't believe. Should be able to make it down there. Right, we should be okay now. We should grab this stuff and be on our way. Too greedy. Now we just need to home in on our other tractor and head towards that. absolutely fantastic. There's another crash site there. That's interesting to know. So that's something that we'll have to keep in mind. I think we're about the path where we need to be now. Oh, this is somewhere where we don't want to be. No, we really don't want to be in there. Oh, get out. Tractor's stuck. Come on. Oh. You have no idea how hard my heart is beating right now. I thought we were done for. Be a safer way back. Oh, now we can get this stuck again, aren't we? Right, let's go this way. I suppose we could always head towards the hub. Maybe that would be the smart idea. Maybe jump this off here. Head this way. Base elevator, so that's also a lightning signal. Oh. Well, that was exciting. Oh, what? No. That just didn't happen. Seriously? How can that happen? Seriously? Right, we're gonna have to get out of the thing, aren't we? And we're gonna have to fight these things. And then maybe if we pick this up, it'll. Yep. Oh, that was just in the nick of time, too, wasn't it? Safer path out. Yeah. to get out and push then. I think I know where I am now. Probably would be an idea to go back to the base because we have got very little fuel at the power plant. So we'll go back to the base to the power plant, and then we'll research all this lovely quartz that we've got. Let's see if we can unlock the buggy. And we can set that thing. And we can set the machines to runners. Can't do that yet, so we can just flip the switch. Change this to rotors. We left the rotors in the other tractor. Not all of us. Have we got a spare constructor anywhere? Go on for a second. Right, I have still have no idea on how that ended up on its front. But I think they're still a little bit. I think the tractors are still a little bit buggy. Just craft some of these to start some motors going. But at least we have plenty of quartz now. Enough to last us for a while. Started. Oops. How many do we need for our next? Where is the map? Oh, we can start sulfur technology as well, can't we? No, because we need 50. In a chest. Might actually have a little bit of that left over. Not enough. Last. So I'll put a chest down here. chest down here. Put some quartz in. Do we need it for quartz? I'll drop all the rest of the garbage off. Put it to this chest. While we're waiting, we could research that purple power stuff, couldn't we? 25 modular frames. Should have modular frames somewhere. Oh, they're at the power plant. I forgot that we're moving all the heavier resources to the power plant. Crystal things, but a lot more. Do the research on that now. Quartz. 50 reinforced plates. Fantastic. Where am I? There. Quartz, crystal oscillator. So we need to build 5 crystal oscillators. How do we build them? Crystal oscillator, what do you cost? Oh, just quartz crystals. Okay. Need a lot of them though. Maybe we'll manually craft some of these crystals. Can we do that? Is that a thing? Yep. Oh, because we've got quartz, does that mean we can start, like, glass? Really excited for glass. Oh, amazing. Do I need to craft silica to unlock glass? Right, that's the 5 oscillators. So, quartz. 3 second research. Oh, there it is. 10 of them, 100 of them. Wow. Oh, mapping. That could be handy. We get the map. Okay, that's happening. Beacon 10. What? What's no? The map? What, you mean don't research the map? 10 oscillators. Number 2. I'll be so much happier when this is all. Oh, no need to build the silicon. Right, okay. Right, I'm with you now. I think the map is going to be super helpful. Right. So what time are we looking at? It's almost 3 o'clock. So at 3 o'clock I'm going to have to go. But I am going to be doing another stream again tonight at some point. I think round about in about 3 hours time from when I finish, I'll be going back live once again. So this one is going to be a grindy day, as I really want to get loads done today. And well, today I'm going to do 2 live streams today, so I'm going to finish in around about 5 minutes. I'm going to try and get this map unlocked, and then I'm going to call it a day, and call it for now. And then in about 3 hours time I'm going to start a new stream, and that's going to be part 2 of this one. So I'll go live again in about 3 hours. Here it's going to be about 6 o'clock in the evening here when I go live again. Let's grab that and that, and those rotors, feed the beast. Hi. That's late. For me it's not really late. 6 o'clock isn't late for me. Oh, it's going to be like 8 o'clock for you. Yeah, the time difference. It's a pain, isn't it? Because normally I would only do like a 2-hour stream today, and then it would be the next day, so I'm going to do another extra two hour stream later on, because I just want to get loads of grindy stuff done. Right, so how many oscillators can we build now? Oh, I need cable. That's all we have absolutely tons of in that container. It'll be about 2 hours. It'll be from like here, like 6 o'clock till 8 o'clock. Yeah, it would be. It would be until about 10 your time. All 5 minutes. So in that time, I'll call it from there for today on part one, and then we'll do part two again and go back live in about 3 hours. That'll give me enough time to get done what I need to get done. AFK modular frames. I feel like I can make 300 of those. I don't want to. I want to make 300. Just take a couple of these out. Still too many. Slap. How many is that gonna make me? It's gonna make 132. That's absolutely fine. So, right. I'm gonna. Yeah, that. Gonna happen, and I need to save it. Don't want to lose my world. So yeah, right. I'll get back on to this bench, craft away at that. So yeah, take care. I'll see you all later. I hope you enjoyed this one. I know it was a grindy episode. In the next one, it's going to be like more complete buildy episode, because we're going to go back to that power plant. We're going to go and try and finish that power plant and get it running, and we're going to go to the factory and start planning where everything's going to go, and maybe put a few structures down so we know what the size of it's going to be. So yeah. Take care, guys. See you all later. Swifty out.